cute, Mom. How cute I was, believe it or not. That is me. I change it, you change. Everything changes all the time. Do you want to know more about this? In this class, you're going to learn how the environment and the habitat change. Okay, check this class. Do not forget, subscribe my channel and like this video. See you next class. Bye bye. Hello everyone, welcome back to one more science class. Woohoo! I love this class. So everybody knows that today we are going to talk about changes. Yes, we change a lot, we grow, we get older. Okay, sometimes we get a new haircut or new clothes, or even we change the places that we live. Sometimes we move to another city, another country, and there's all fine, okay? But the class that we have today is about change. But the question is, how do the habitats change? Let's start. I have a question for you. Do you recognize this place? Yes? No? What an old picture. Mm-hmm, I agree. If you don't recognize this, you can pause this video and even call your mother or your father to help you. Let's see if they know. No, it's still hard. So let's move on. Let's see. And now, can you recognize this place? Yes, for sure. This is our beautiful, amazing Paulista Avenue. I love this place. So see how this has changed from this to this, but this wasn't so fast, took a while. And now we are going to see who changed the habitat. Let's see. So some of these changes that happens in the habitats are caused by a natural change and some are caused by the human change. That is okay, we have two different kinds. The human can change and can be natural, okay? And all of them are good, all of them are bad. Some are good and some are bad. Let's keep move on to learning more about it. So natural changes. Let's see some examples of flooding. Sometimes happens, sometimes it's raining a lot. And what else? Forest fires, yes, sometimes the weather is too dry and too hot, okay? It's all natural change. What else? Volcano eruption, yes, nobody put a fire there. Just happening, we don't know why. Let's see, yes, we know why, but we're not studying this in this class. And tornadoes, all of them, they're natural changes, okay? So, and how about the human change, teacher? Let's see some example. What comes in your mind when you think, oh, changes that are caused by a human being? Let's see. So, human change, let's see. Pollution, what else? Think a little bit, let's go. Traffic, yes. What else? Cleaning land, they clean a land to build schools, houses, shopping mall, right? And what else? One more? Think a little bit. Building dams. Yes, that is true. There is a process that humans here, they do to produce electricity, okay? So all those changes, even the natural ones and the human ones are only bad. What do you think? So, some natural changes are good because, see here an example. Sometimes the natural places needs to change for what? To grow over again, everything brand new, okay? With tourists in here. So, they start to grow all the plants and the tree again. And here, this volcano. Lava, it's full of minerals. So when the lava touches
the ocean. Here, the water become rich in mineral as well, okay? So some of these changes are pretty good to the environment and there's okay to happen. And by the way, we cannot control, okay? This is a part of a natural cycle. So let's see, some human change, there's also good. Let's see some. Sometimes they can even, like the human people, can clean ocean. They are changing the habitat somehow. Oh, that is a nice one. Sometimes they build bridges here to the animals so they can cross here without the risk of getting hit by the car, okay? And then another one, growing plants. Yes, the human, they can start plant trees and all over again, okay? And recycling, guys, it's just amazing way to try to change this, okay? So what we learned from this class? Change happen can be by natural or caused by a human, and some of them are positive and some of them are negative, right? So here I have two questions for you. The first one, I want you to think that if human or nature cause more change in the habitat, what do you think? Human or nature? One thing that I think that when the changes are caused by nature, they are really fast. Okay, like a tornado happens really fast. And the human, they change in a kind of a slowly way. Okay, but I want you to think, who does more changes here in the habitat, the human or the nature? Okay, so I want you to write, I think nature causes more change because blah, 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 blah. So it's your turn to express what you think. And the second one is, in your notebook, create another two column table, like one column, two column table, just like this one. And then I want you guys to list positive changes that human causes and negative changes. Or negative can be pollution and positive can be cleaning the ocean, okay? When you finish this, you also can ask your family to see if they have something to add or if they agree with you guys, okay? So for today, this is our science class. I hope you enjoy it. Do not forget to follow my channel and like this video. See you in a little bit. Bye-bye.